Hi. Good morning. Good afternoon. And we all are here to attend today's storytelling session with Neeraj Dada. Hi, Neeraj Dada. Good to see you.
Hello. Good to see everybody. Hi, how are you guys?
Yes, good to see you. And Neeraj Dada, let me introduce him. He's a storyteller, he's improviser, and he teaches in one IB international school. And he's also a theater practitioner. So today he's going to tell us a story. And before that, we are going to listen our little storyteller. And let me welcome Ishan Puranik as well. Hi, Ishan. So are you ready with your story? Yes, so let's listen to Ishan first and then we'll move ahead to Neeraj Dada's story. Yes, Ishan, over to you.
Hello, hi सगळ्यांना. आज मी जी गोष्ट सांगणार आहे ती कोणाची तुम्हाला माहिती आहे का? ती आपल्या आवडत्या शिवाजी महाराजांच्या एका शूर मावळ्याची. माझ्या गोष्टीचं नाव आहे नियमप्रिय सावळे पांडे. शिवाजी महाराजांनी आपल्या गडावरील लोकांसाठी काही नियम बनवले होते आणि त्यातीलच एक नियम हा होता की सूर्योदयापूर्वी आणि सूर्यास्तानंतर कोणालाही गडावर प्रवेश नाही. शिवाजी महाराजांचा असा आदेश होता की सर्व किल्लेदारांनी या नियमांचं काटेकोरपणे पालन करावं. अशाच एका गडावर सावळ्या तांडेल नावाचा एक शूर मावळा पहारा देत होता. सूर्यास्त झाला, सगळीकडे अंधार पसरला. तेवढ्यात एक सरदार आपल्या घोड्यावरून गडाच्या प्रवेशद्वाराजवळ आला. सावळ्याने नियमाप्रमाणे त्या सरदाराला अडवलं. तो सरदार म्हणाला, अरे मी तर सरदार आहे, मला ज्याला काय हरकत आहे. तरी सावळ्याने त्या सरदाराला गडावर प्रवेश दिला नाही. त्या सरदाराला खूप राग आला आणि त्या सरदारने आपली तलवार बाहेर काढून घोड्यावरून खाली उतरला. हे बघता सावळ्याने आपली तलवार बाहेर काढली आणि युद्धासाठी सज्ज झाला. मग तो सरदार सावळ्याच्या जवळ जाऊन म्हणाला, अरे सावळ्या, मी शिवाजी महाराज आहे, तुम्हाला ओळखलं नाहीस का, मला आज सोड. हे ऐकून सावळ्या थोडासा चपापला. पण सावळ्याला काय, नियम पाळायचं एवढंच माहिती. सावळ्या म्हणाला, महाराज तुम्ही प्रत्यक्ष शिवाजी महाराज जरी असला तरी मी तुम्हाला आज सोडूचा नाय. शिवाजी महाराज गालातल्या गालात असले आणि परतले. त्या रात्री शिवाजी महाराजांनी गडाच्या जवळच्या एका गावात मुक्काम केला आणि सकाळी परत गडावर गेले. दरबार भरला. शिवाजी महाराजांनी असा आदेश दिला की सावळ्याला बोलवा. पण तोपर्यंत ही बातमी सगळीकडे पसरलेली होती आणि सगळ्यांचं लक्ष ह्याच्याकडे गेलं होतं की आता शिवाजी महाराज सावळ्याचं काय करणार. सावळ्या आला आणि अपराधी मनाने शिवाजी महाराजांच्या समोर मान खाली घालून उभा राहिला. शिवाजी महाराज म्हणाले, सावळ्या काल तूच गडावर पहारा देत होतास ना, आता तरी तुला पटलं की तो सरदार म्हणजेच आम्ही. आता ज्यांनी प्रत्यक्ष शिवाजी महाराजांना आज जाऊ दिला नाही त्याला मी काय शिक्षा द्यावी. सावळ्या म्हणाला, महाराज पण मी तुम्ही सांगितलेल्याच नियमांचं पालन करत होतो, पण प्रत्यक्ष शिवाजी महाराजांना मी आज जाऊ नाही हे माझं चुकलं, मला हवी आहे ती शिक्षा द्या. शिवाजी महाराज म्हणाले, अरे सावळ्या तू वेडा आहेस का, मी तुला शिक्षा द्यायला नाही उलट बक्षीस द्यायला इकडे बोलवले आहे. हे ऐकता सगळे आश्चर्यचकित झाले आणि शिवाजी महाराजांनी आपल्या हातातलं कडं सावळ्याच्या हातात घातलं. जसं सावळ्याने आपलं कर्तव्य काटेकोरपणे पार पाडलेलं असतं तसं शिवाजी महाराजांचं मन कौतुक, कारण त्यांनी स्वतः बनवलेले नियम स्वतःच्या वागण्यात सर्वांना दाखवलेले असतात. सो फ्रेंड्स, आता आपण जी गोष्ट ऐकली तिच्यात शिवाजी महाराजांनी महाराज असून पण नियमांचं उल्लंघन केलं नाही. तर आपण पण आपले पेरेंट्स, टीचर्स, मंदार दादा, दीपालीताई जे रूल्स सांगतात ते फॉलो करायला पाहिजे, कारण ते आपल्या चांगल्यासाठीच असतात. हो ना?
What a beautiful story, Ishan. That was so wonderful. I am so happy and glad that you shared such a beautiful thought with us. And yes, whenever the older people like me are sharing some rules and telling you some things to follow, you all should. And Neeraj Dada, what was your reaction with Ishan's story?
So beautiful, such good expressions, and also such detail he was telling his story with. Very good, Ishan. I really like the way you told the story. And I was very happy. It was a very good message. And so positive. It's one more story I have never heard. And it will also inspire me to follow rules.
Thank you, Neeraj Dada.
Yes, good to know that. And here we start Neeraj Dada's story. Are you all excited?
Yes,
I can see that. I'm also excited to hear Neeraj Dada's story after Ishan's. And yes, Neeraj Dada, so we all are eager to hear a story from you.
So, hello everybody. I'm Neeraj. And today I'm going to tell you a story from the ancient land of Africa. Okay, so this is an African folk tale that has been told, retold many times, but I'm going to tell it to you again. So once upon a time, there was an old lady and she had a stick, and she used to live at the steep of the hill, and she had a very beautiful daughter who used to live up the hill. And every weekend, she used to climb up the stairs and go to meet her daughter, because her daughter was an excellent cook and she used to love what she cooks. She used to go there, thin lady used to go there, eat a lot, become fat and come down. And again, when she gets thin, she used to go again up. So in the morning, she woke up. She went and saw herself in the mirror. I think I've gone thin again. It's time to go up. And she wore her hat. She put some perfume. She took her stick and started to walk. Okay, you need to help me walk the lady. Okay, there's a rhythm to help me walk. So this is how she started to walk. Hold your stick, everybody. Hold your stick like this. Yeah. So, rickety-rick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with the walking stick. And she sees somebody. Oh!
Where are you going, your lady? I am a wolf, and I am hungry, and I want to eat you.
Oh, Wolfie, Wolfie, I'm just a thin old lady. What will you eat? I have the small bones, no skin. If you eat me, I will not be there even in your teeth. Let me go up to my daughter, where she will give me delicious things to drink and delicious things to eat. I will become fat and I will have a lot of muscle. Then you can eat me.
Okay, come back. I'll be waiting for you.
And then she started to walk faster up the hill. Help me walk the lady with a stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I... Everybody, where's the stick? I can't see the stick. The lady will not walk. Come on, everybody. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick, here I come with my walking stick. Then she saw somebody on two legs, standing like this, saying, This is a bear. Okay, the bear says, Oh lady, where do you think you're going? It's my lunch time and I'm gonna eat you. Beary bear, you are a silly bear. Look at me, I'm so thin. Even if you eat me, I'll not fill your stomach. Let me go up where my daughter will give me delicious things to drink and delicious things to eat. Then I'll become fat and I'll come down. Then you can eat me.
sound nice. Go, go, come back. I will eat you.
And the lady now started walking. And she's tired. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. Here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. Here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. And there is some another animal with small ears, whiskers, and stripes on the body. And he says, this is a tiger. That's right.
Daddy, I'm going to eat you for my lunch. Joseph, you look very juicy.
Tiger, you tiger. You cute tiger. Look at me. You want to eat me? Come eat me. But look at me. I'm so thin. What will happen? You'll have to eat 10 old ladies to fill your stomach. Let me go up. Then my daughter has made delicious things to drink and delicious to eat. And once I eat those things, I'll become so fat and come down that you can eat me and fill your stomach.
This is a trick.
No. Tiger. An old lady always keeps a promise. I will come down and then you can eat me.
Okay, go. I'm waiting.
Then the lady walked up. Oh, rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. Here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. Here I come with my walking stick. Rick-a-tick-a-rick, rick-a-tick-a-rick. Here I come with my walking stick. And then she takes a stick and knocks on the door. And the daughter opens, oh, my mama, and goes and hugs her. Come inside, see what all I have I cooked for you. Okay? Now, she comes there, and she sees a table full of food. What all does she see? She sees samosa. She sees gulab jamun. She sees biryani. She sees a lot of juices. She sees fruits. She sees, what else does she see? Can somebody add to the list? What does she see? Can somebody tell me? Just unmute yourself and tell me.
Pizza. Burger.
Pizza. Burger.
Sandwich.
Yes, that also.
Ice and cream. French fries.
French fries, ice cream. Everything is there. And now there is also pumpkin juice. Okay, that is the specialty of our sister.
Ice cream.
Yes, we love ice cream. Big towers of ice cream is there. And now she comes and sits down and starts to eat. And one dish, second dish, third dish, ice cream. And now she's almost full. Now the doctor says, oh, mama, it's all good, but you did not drink my pumpkin juice. Ah, yes. Please get me the pumpkin juice. She gets the pumpkin juice and she takes the spoon and help me drink. She does this. Ah. Ah. Such nice pumpkin juice. I've never had such good pumpkin juice ever. And she loves the pumpkin juice. She's so filled that she has to unbutton herself to take out two buttons. Her stomach is coming out and she has become so fat. And she takes a stick and is about to go. And she realizes, there are 3 people waiting for me down. What should I do? I promised them that I'll become fat and they can eat me. And then the daughter said, you see that pumpkin there? Yeah. Can you go inside that? Squeeze yourself a little and go inside. He's like, yes. And she went inside and took her stick inside. And the lady is sitting down. The daughter took the lid of the pumpkin, put it up and waxed it all around. So the pumpkin is tight. And now she said, and she made small holes in the pumpkin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that the old lady could breathe. Now she said, don't worry. What I'm going to do is I'm going to push the pumpkin down. And as the pumpkin goes down, you can roll down to your house and reach there and relax. Nobody will trouble you. Okay? Help me roll the pumpkin. Here I come, rolling down, here I come.
Bam! What is this?
This is a pumpkin, but it smells like an old lady. No. I am just a pumpkin, just going my way. I am not an old lady. Why do you smell like an old lady? Oh, no, tiger tie. I am not an old lady. I am just a pumpkin. Just push me ahead.
Where is that old lady? Have you seen her?
I don't know about any old lady. I am just a pumpkin. Okay. And the tiger pushes. And it again starts to roll. Here I come on my pumpkin.
Pumpkin, are you a pumpkin or are you the old lady?
I'm the pumpkin. I'm not the old lady.
How can I believe you? You smell like the old lady.
I am not the old lady. I'm the pumpkin. Please let the pumpkin go.
Where's the old lady?
I don't know. Maybe she's coming.
She has promised me that she will come and I will have
my lunch. The old lady is good. She will keep her promises. But please push me. Let me go ahead.
Okay.
And the pumpkin goes, Here I come on my pumpkin. And thom! Now she reaches the wolf. And the wolf like, ow! There is something fishy in this pumpkin. It smells like the old lady. I am very suspicious. No, I am Mr. Pumpkin. I am not the old lady.
No, there's something fishy.
And the wolf climbs on the pumpkin and uses its claw and his nose and his feet and starts to dig. Oh. Ow. And opens the lid of the pumpkin. But the lady has a stick. And as it goes down to smell, the lady takes the stick and jabs it. And the wolf runs away. And the lady comes out of the pumpkin. Her house is in the front. She goes in. Rick-a-tick-rick, and opens the door and goes inside, locks it, and goes, puts on her gas, makes some tea, and she is satisfied. So that is the first story that is there. Okay, I'll also tell you another story. That's a second story too.
Of course, children would love to listen another story. Yes, children? See, there are so many thumbs up.
Yes.
All right. Let us have another story. This story is of a tribe near one day on a full moon, when the moon is full, a baby was born. And this baby had a cry of a lion. He cried like the lion is roaring. And everybody was so scared. Like, oh my God. Who's this? Why is he not crying like a normal human child? Why is he crying like a lion? And among all this thing, the priest came and he said, this boy either will become a very rich man or will become the greatest hunter. And the boy chose the second. He wanted to become a hunter. So he went out and he met all his hunter friends, all small children who wanted to become hunters later. Because a tribe hunts. They don't grow anything. They go in the forest, they find a deer, they hunt it, they bring it, they cook it and eat. That is how they live. They need hunters. And their training began. They used to go in the jungle and look at the deer for hours, hiding in the tree. They used to learn how to do archery, how to throw a bow, how to use their sword, how to kill, how to capture, and how to move like wind and make no noise. They used to go in the jungle and had eyes of the owl. See, I'd see a deer. Hit. Ah! Go, take it. And they were trained like this, all of them. But this boy, he was the sharpest. From the time he had held his bow, not one arrow had missed. If he had shot 100 arrows, he had killed 100 animals. And as he grew up, he became the greatest hunter. And throughout the village, whatever meat was given, this hunter used to provide. He used to go to hunt, kill, get the meat. And he said, no hunting, only I will hunt. You guys relax, because I'm the greatest hunter. And because he was so great, the chief of the tribe married his daughter with him. And now he had power, he had influence, he had money, and he could do anything. He said, he thought for oneself, I am God. Whatever I say happens in the village. And he was so proud of himself. And then, after some time, he had a small child. And he said, okay, what name do... Then tribal people asked him, you are the greatest hunter. Your child will become greater than you. What will you name him? He said, whatever I name him, it's choice. But on his name day, the day I give him, his name, I'm going to sacrifice one leopard cub. Leopard cub. It was difficult to catch a leopard cub because a lioness, the mother will always look for the cub. If you go nearby, even 1 kilometer, she will jump on you and kill you. How can you get her? I am the greatest hunter who ever lived. What do you think? I cannot do. I have never caught a leopard's child, but today, for my child, I am going to sacrifice one leopard cub. And everybody said, okay, we are sure that you can do. And everybody sang, and everybody danced, and everybody beat drums to give him energy. And he got his gear. And he sharpened his sword. And he was ready to go. And he went into the jungle. He crossed rivers. He crossed jungles. He crossed rocks. And then he went to the place where the cubs were. And he saw that two little cubs with small fingers were playing each other, rolling on each other, trying to kiss each other, and trying to move, wag their tails. And he saw, where is the mother? I wanted to kill one, but the nature is saying, let me kill two, maybe one for my child, one for my beautiful wife. And for a second, these cows were playing. The other second, they were in mid-air. And the third second, inside the hunter's bag, in complete darkness. And he walked through the jungle. There's bow ready. Okay? He walked to see if the leopardess will come and try and take her children. No. No leopardess. Aha. And he kept inside. He's reached the village. Okay, yeah. And he showed. See what I've got. Everybody clapped. Ah, the hunter is the greatest. He caught the lioness cub. Nobody has done that. And everybody sang for his bravery. Then he put these cubs inside a cage. A small cage made up with stick and rocks. Just a temporary one till the morning. So the next day he can cut them and say that, oh, see, for my son, I have done this. But in the jungle, the leopardess had caught a deer and was getting the deer to train her kids on how to eat meat with their teeth. Now, she came and saw. Where are my children? She could not smell her children, but she picked one smell. Smell of a two-legged animal. Ah, it's a man. A man has been here and he has taken my children. And she followed. And she reached to a hilltop from where she could see the village. And she was sure that my kids are there. But she could not go there in the sun. If she had gone there, somebody would kill her. So she waited patiently. And in the village, as people sang and beat their drums, dum 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 dum, and sing, and the ladies are singing to their children, putting them into cradles. La balamo, la balamo, la balamo. And as the food is being made, smoke is coming out of the chimney, the sky is setting down, and the sun is slowly, slowly becoming dimmer. The leopard is still waiting. The sun came down, leopard is still waiting. The sun is almost going to go down and the sky is going to be dark, leopard is still waiting. As the sun came down, the leopardess transformed herself into a beautiful woman with golden hair, beautiful face, and had a cloth that was made up of leopard skin. Then she walked to the village. And she went to the hunter's door and knocked. Hello, hi. Actually, I am a visitor. I was just traveling by. It is very dark. Can I stay here for the night? And I was like, oh, yeah, of course. Who says no to visitors? Visitors of God like us. Come inside. And she came inside and sat. The hunter had made some food and he asked her to eat. Eat. This is a deer that I hunted. You will like the taste. Eat. And she started to eat. But she had not come to eat. Her nose was active. And she picked the smell of her children. And she saw those cages. Oh, they are kept here. And her heart leapt. She wanted to jump and catch and run. But hunter was there. She could not. So she sat there and started to eat. But she was agitated inside. She was so angry. And she asked the hunter, "Ha, I see that you have two leopard kids. What is the purpose of them?
Ah, yes, these. Tomorrow is my child's
names or money. I'm going to sacrifice one and one for my beautiful daughter. Oh, is that so? Can you leave one and sacrifice only one? Maybe one can be left. Think about the poor mother of these children. She must be feeling so bad. What? What are you suggesting? Who are you? You are a stranger in my house. I gave you food. Don't you dare talk to me like that. Sit down and eat your food. Okay? But you know, if you give me the chance, I can take one and leave in the jungle and maybe you can... What kind of a lady are you? How dare you tell me to come in my house and question my own ways? You are out of bound right now. Shut up and eat or leave. And she started crying. Please, don't do this. Don't do this. They are just little children. Think about the mother. Why will I think about the mother? I am a hunter. I don't think about emotions of animals. I am going to sacrifice both of them. And one more word, you. These women, all they know is to cry. Don't question me. How dare you? One more word from you and you can leave. And she dried her tears and said, so you will not listen to me. Said, no, why will I listen to you? Who are you? Tell me. And she jumped on him, changed herself into a leopardess before he could grab his arrow, grab his knife or grab anything. His throat was slit, his body was teared and he died. And she looked at the cage and she saw her two children and tried to open the cage. But to open the cage, you require nimble fingers of a human being, not of a tiger cannot open a cage. So the leopardess changed back to the lady. She went and she opened the cage. She took her children out and stuck to herself. The children, though, did not recognize her face, but understood her smell and did not make any noise. And as the tribe was sleeping, there was smoke in the chimney, the drums were feeding. She took them to the jungle, changed herself into the leopardess and went back home. The next morning, everybody was waiting for the name ceremony. The whole village gathered that, okay, there will be a great sacrifice. And they started calling the hunter out. The hunter did not come out. Then they started singing for the hunter. Maybe the hunter wants some praise. And hunter did not come out. Then they started dancing. And it did not come out. And then they started the drums. Thum, 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 thum. It did not come out. Then the wife of the hunter got worried. And she went and opened the door. And she saw something. And the way she screamed, had you been there, your ears will be ringing. But at the same time, in the jungle, the cubs were playing small leopard games. They were singing small leopard songs. And while they slept, they saw little leopard dreams. So that is a folk tale again from Africa that I've adapted to tell to you guys. So that is the second story.
Such a nice and beautiful story it was, and I liked it. What about you guys? Yes, so Kritika, how was the story?
Mala avadu.
Great, okay. Ishan?
I never heard such story. Very nice. I liked it.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Teertha? Nice. Okay. Agam.
I like it.
It was very good.
Great.
It was,
okay.
Chikasa. A very story.
I liked it. It was very good.
Yes, it was nice, Vivan. Okay. Riyansh.
It was very nice story. Thank you, sir, for telling.
Sharyu?
Thank you, sir.
It was interesting.
Very interesting. Yes, indeed. Okay, so thank you, Neeraj Dada, for this wonderful storytelling session. And I hope you all are going to join Neeraj Dada back for acting sessions. Okay, so he is also going to come for acting sessions after 2 days. And he will be conducting improvisation sessions. He will let you know what improvisation means and why it is important in theater and acting. And those who know already will enjoy the entire process of improvisation. All right. So here we go, and we'll finish today's session by now. And yes, thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you all.
Okay, so we'll just say bye to all our friends and we'll...
Bye.
Yeah. Bye. 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 Bye.